Hi students, this is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8, no problem number 3. Solve the following equations. Totally we have 11 subdivisions. We can do one by one. Here we have question number 3, subdivision number 1. Here in between the trigonometric function we have the sign minus. So you have to apply sine c minus sine d identity. We know that sine c minus sine d that is equal to 2 cos of c plus d by 2 into sine of c minus d by 2. Here c that is equal to 5x and d that is equal to x. So 2 cos c plus d 5x plus x divided by 2 sine c minus d by 2 that is 5x minus x by 2 that is equal to cos 3x. Which implies 2 cos of 5x plus x that is equal to 6x, 6x by 2 that is equal to 3x, sine 5x minus 1x equal to 4x, 4x by 2 that is equal to 2x, it comes left hand side minus cos 3x that is equal to 0. Between these two you can take cos 3x is common, cos 3x into here 2 sine 2x minus, since you have taken cos 3x is common, here 1 will be there, that is equal to 0. Product of these two equals 0 means either cos 3x equals 0 or 2 sine 2x minus 1 equals 0. Double cases. Case 1 and case 2. Case 1. Cos 3x that is equal to 0. Here you are not given any interval in that question. So you have tried the general solution. Remember, for all the problems you have tried the general solution only. In the previous problem you were given that interval 0 to 360 degree. Do you remember? The previous problem you were given 0 to 360 degree. Here if you are not given one, you have tried the general solution for all the problems. Here cos 3x that is equal to 0. We know that if cos theta equals 0, then theta that is equal to 2n pi, 2n plus 1 into pi by 2, where n belongs to integer. That's the general solution. So instead of theta, we have 3x, which implies this is theta. So instead of theta, theta equals, that is 3x equals 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. We need x. Therefore, x equals 2n plus 1 into pi divided by 3 to 6. N belongs to integer. Case 1 over. Now, case 2, 2 sine 2x minus 1 equals 0. Case 2, 2 sine 2x minus 1 equals 0. Which implies 2 sine 2x that is equal to plus 1 comes right, minus 1 comes right and say plus 1, which implies sine 2x that is equal to 1 by 2. We know that the principal value of sine between minus 90 and plus 90, sine is here. Since it is positive greater than 0, definitely it lies in first quadrant, not in fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant sign is negative, right, which is greater than 0, which implies sine 2x that is equal to, since the angle in first quadrant you have tried sine pi by 6, pi by 6 that is equal to 30 degrees, sine 30 that is equal to 1 by 2, 30 degree lies in which quadrant? First quadrant. Now what form it is? This is of the form sine theta that is equal to sine alpha. We know that If sine theta equals sine alpha, we know that if sine theta that is equal to sine alpha, then theta that is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n into alpha, n belongs to integers, set of all integers. Instead of theta, we have 2x, this is theta, this one is alpha. So which implies theta equals, instead of theta we have 2x, that is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n into alpha, alpha that is equal to pi by 6, which implies x equals, have to divide here, if you divide now you will be getting n pi by 2 plus minus 1 power n, here also you have to divide because in between you have plus symbol, both to be divided by 2, 2 6 are 12 and belongs to set of all integer. That's all, subdivision 1 is over, then I'll be teaching that subdivision number 2 in the next video. Thank you children. Hi student, this is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8, now problem number 3, subdivision number 2. Solve the equation 2 cos square theta plus 3 sin theta minus 3 that is equal to 0. We have cos square theta and sin theta, but we know the formula for cos square theta. This can be replaced by 1 minus sin square theta plus 3 sin theta minus 3 equals 0. Now multiply by 2, 2 into 1, 2, 2 into sin square theta, 2 sin square theta plus 3 sin theta minus 3 equals 0. Right, minus 2 sin square theta plus 3 sin theta, and add the constant 2 minus 3 that is equal to minus 1 equal to 0. We got the quadratic equation in terms of sine, but look at the sine. So look at the sign here, negative, you have to multiply it by minus. If you multiply it by minus, minus 2 becomes plus 2 sin square theta, plus becomes minus 3 sin theta, and minus 1 becomes plus 1, that is equal to 0. Now we can factorize the coefficient of sin square theta equals 2 into 1, that is 2, and coefficient of sin theta that is equal to minus 3. The two terms are minus 2 and minus 1. If you add the two numbers, you are getting minus 3. If you multiply the two numbers, you are getting plus 2. Now, splitting the middle terms, 2 sin square theta, write as it is. Instead of minus 3 sin theta, you can write minus 2 sin theta and minus 1 sin theta plus 1 at the last equals 0. Now, grouping. Between the two, you can take 2 sin theta as common, sin theta minus 1. Here, just inside the bracket, we have sin theta minus 1, right? Once again, here we have minus sin theta, so put minus 1. Minus 1 into sin theta, minus into minus, plus 1, that is equal to 0. Here, between these two, you can take sin theta minus 1 as common, into 2 sin theta minus 1. That is equal to 0. Product of these two equals 0 means either sin theta minus 1 equal to 0 or 2 sin theta minus 1 equal to 0. Double cases. Now case 1. Sin theta minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, sin theta that is equal to plus 1, which implies sin theta that is equal to 1 can be replaced by sin 90. Sin 90 that is equal to 1. Because the principal value of sin theta lies from minus 90 to plus 90. Since 1 is positive, you have to consider only sin 90. We know that what form it is, sin theta that is equal to sin alpha, then theta that is equal to, we know that sin theta that is equal to sin alpha, then theta that is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n into alpha, where n belongs to set of all integers. Here theta, that is theta only, this is alpha, theta only here. So theta that is equal to, which implies theta that is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n into alpha, alpha that is equal to pi by 2, where n belongs to integer. Case 1 is over. Now case 2, 2 sin theta minus 1 equals 0. Therefore, 2 sin theta that is equal to plus 1. Then sin theta that is equal to 1 by 2, which is greater than 0. The principal value of sin theta lies between minus 90 and plus 90. It's a first quadrant and a fourth quadrant. Since it is positive in which quadrant? Definitely the first quadrant, which implies sin theta that is equal to sin pi by 6. Pi by 6 that is equal to 30 degree. 30 degree lies in which quadrant? First quadrant, because 1 by 2 is positive. What form it is? Sin theta equal to sin alpha here. Same. Sin theta equal sin alpha, theta that is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n into alpha. Here theta, this is theta only. Theta, this one is alpha, which implies theta that is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n into alpha, alpha that is equal to pi by 6, where n belongs to integer. That is a solution. So, subdivision 2, problem number 3, subdivision 2 is completed, and I will be teaching that subdivision number 3 in the next video. Thank you, children. Hi, student, this is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now, problem number 3, subdivision number 3. Solve the following equation: cos theta plus cos 3 theta that is equal to 2 cos 2 theta. Here we have third subdivision. In between trigonometry functions we have a plus symbol, so you have to consider as C and D. Since cos C plus cos D that is equal to 2 cos of C plus D by 2 into cos of C minus D by 2, C that is theta, D that is 3 theta, which implies 2 cos C plus D, theta plus 3 theta, divided by 2 cos of C minus D, that is theta minus 3 theta, divided by 2, that is equal to 2 cos 2 theta. Now 2 into cos of 1 theta plus 3 theta, that is 4 theta, 4 theta by 2, that is equal to 2 theta, into cos of theta minus 3 theta, that is equal to minus 2 theta, divided by 2, that is equal to minus theta. When it comes left hand side, minus 2 cos 2 theta, that is equal to 0, which implies 2 cos 2 theta into, we know very well cos of minus theta and cos theta are same, minus 2 cos 2 theta equals 0. Now you can take 2 cos 2 theta as common. If you take common, here you will be getting cos theta, here minus 1, that is equal to 0. Product of these two equals 0 means, before that we can divide by 2. If we divide by 2, you will be getting cos 2 theta into cos theta minus 1, that is equal to 0 by 2 equals 0. Product of these two equals 0 means either cos 2 theta equals 0 or cos theta minus 1 equals 0. Double cases. Now case 1. Cos 2 theta that is equal to 0. So what form it is? Already we have theta, so right here we know that instead of theta I write cos x that is equal to 0 then x equals 2n plus 1 into pi by 2, where n belongs to integers. This is x. Since we have theta, instead of theta I have considered cos x, remember, because I have given in the formula list cos theta equals 0, instead of theta I mentioned x here, okay, which implies x. Instead of x we have 2 theta, that is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2, where n belongs to integer. You need only theta, therefore theta, that is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi, 2 are 4, n belongs to integer. This is case 1. Case 1 solution is over. Now case 2. Case 2, cos theta minus 1 equals 0. Case 2, cos theta minus 1 equal to 0, which implies cos theta, that is equal to minus 1 comes right hand side, plus 1, that is equal to cos theta, that is equal to cos 0 degree, cos 0 that is equal to 1, because the principal value of cos lies from 0 to 180 degree. 0 to 180 degree. So that cos 0, that is equal to 1. Okay. Now theta, that is equal to 0 degree. So what form it is? If cos theta equal to cos alpha, I write that form here. Since if cos theta, that is equal to cos alpha, then theta, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha n belongs to integer. That is the solution. Here we have theta, same theta only. This is theta, this one is alpha, which implies theta, that is theta only, equals 2n pi plus or minus alpha, that is equal to 0, which implies theta, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus 0, 2n pi, if you add with plus or minus 0, we'll be getting only 2n pi. So n belongs to integer. Here representation of angle in degree, here representation of angle in radian, same only, 0 degree and 0, same only. So theta, that is equal to 2n pi. So problem number 3, subdivision 3 is over. Then I'll be teaching problem number 3, subdivision number 4 in the next video. Thank you, children. Hi student, this is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now question number 3, subdivision number 4. Solve the equation sin theta plus sin 3 theta plus sin 5 theta, that is equal to 0. This is of the form sin c plus sin d. Sin c plus sin d, that is equal to 2 sin of c plus d by 2 into cos of c minus d by 2. If we consider this is c and d, no chance of getting sin phi theta. See, look at that, this is c, this is d. 1 theta plus 3 theta, that is equal to 4 theta, 4 theta by 2, that is equal to 2 theta. No sin 2 theta here. Then 1 theta minus 3 theta, that is minus 2 theta divided by 2, that is equal to minus theta. We have sin phi theta, so that I consider this is d. So instead of 3 theta, I consider 5 theta as d. So c, that is theta, d, that is 5 theta. Okay, which implies 2 into sine of c plus d, that is theta plus 5 theta divided by 2 into cos of theta minus 5 theta divided by 2 plus sin 3 theta. The middle term we haven't taken, so write sin 3 theta, that is equal to 0. So 2 into sine of 1 theta plus 5 theta, that is 6 theta by 2, that is equal to 3 theta into cos of 1 theta minus 5 theta, that is equal to minus 4 theta by 2, that is equal to minus 2 theta plus sine 3 theta, that is equal to 0. Next step, 2 sine 3 theta. We know that cos of minus theta, that is equal to cos theta. Cos of minus theta, that is equal to cos theta. Therefore, cos of minus 2 theta, that is equal to cos 2 theta plus sine 3 theta, that is equal to 0. Now, common only sine 3 theta. If we take sine 3 theta as common, here we will be getting 2 cos 2 theta plus, we have taken sine 3 theta as common, you will be getting plus 1, that is equal to 0. So, product of these two equals 0 means either sine 3 theta equals 0 or 2 cos 2 theta plus 1 equals 0. So, double cases. Now, case 1, sine 3 theta, that is equal to 0. This is of the form, already we have theta here, I consider sin x equal to 0. If sin x equal to 0, then x that is equal to n pi, where n belongs to integer. So, which implies this is x. Instead of x, we have 3 theta, that is equal to n pi, which implies theta, that is equal to n pi by 3. N belongs to integer. This is one solution. Now, case number 2, 2 cos 2 theta plus 1 equals 0. 2 cos 2 theta plus 1 equals 0. Which implies 2 cos 2 theta, that is equal to minus 1, plus 1 comes right hand side minus 1, then cos 2 theta, that is equal to minus 1 by 2, which is less than 0. We know the principal solution of cos theta. Cos theta lies from 0 to 180 degree. 0, this is 180 degrees. Since it is negative, cos theta, here first quadrant, second quadrant. If cos theta is positive, that will be in first quadrant. Since cos theta is negative, that will be in second quadrant only. In second quadrant, sine and cosecant only positive, cos is negative only. So, the angle will be cos 2 theta, that is equal to cos of, this is 180 minus alpha. 180 minus alpha. Here, alpha, that is equal to, we know that cos 60 degree, that is equal to 1 by 2. That should be considered as, sorry, pi by 3. Pi by 3, that is 60 degree. Cos 60 degree, that is equal to 1 by 2. That should be considered as alpha. That is pi by 3. Pi minus pi by 3. That is equal to pi minus alpha. So, which implies cos 2 theta, that is equal to cos of pi minus pi by 3, that is equal to 2 pi by 3. For your verification, I do it here. Pi by 3, that is equal to 60. 60 into 2, 120. Cos 120 degree, that is equal to cos of 180 minus 60. 180 minus 60 is 120 degree. Now, you can go for ASTC concept. In ASTC, for 180, cos becomes cos, angle is 60. 180 minus, 180 minus here, 180 plus here. 180 minus lies in which quadrant? Second quadrant, sine only positive. What is here? Cos, therefore it is negative minus cos 60 value, that is equal to 1 by 2. Look at that, minus 1 by 2, we got it. Okay. So, 120 degree, that lies in this interval only, because cos principal value lies from 0 degree to 180 degree. So which implies what form it is? Since we have theta, I consider E as x. If cos x, that is equal to cos alpha. I write here, if cos x, that is equal to cos alpha, then x, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha, where n belongs to integer, which implies this is x, I consider as x, this one I consider as alpha. Instead of x, we have 2 theta. 2n pi plus or minus alpha, alpha that is equal to 2 pi by 3, which implies we need only theta, therefore divide by 2. If we divide by 2, we'll be getting theta. If we divide by 2, we'll be getting n pi, 2 to get cancelled. If we divide by 2, 2 2 get cancelled, we'll be getting pi by 3 here plus or minus pi by 3, where n belongs to integer. So subdivision number 4, question number 3, subdivision number 4 is over. Now I'll be teaching that subdivision number 5 in the next video. Thank you, children. Student, this is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8, problem number 3, subdivision number 5. Solve the following equation: sine 2 theta minus cos 2 theta minus sine theta plus cos theta, that is equal to 0. Here we have subdivision number 5. There is no formula for sine c minus cos d, but we have sine c minus sine d and cos c minus cos d. So grouping sine 2 theta minus sine theta plus, I write this one, cos theta minus cos 2 theta. Cos theta minus cos 2 theta. Then only you can apply the formula cos c minus cos d. That is equal to 0. Here, this is c. This one is d. Here, this is c. This is d. So, two formulae to be applied, sin c minus sin d and cos c minus cos d. Sin c minus sin d, that is equal to 2 cos of c plus d by 2 into sin of c minus d by 2. And cos c minus cos d equals cos c minus cos d, that is equal to minus 2 sin of c plus d by 2 into sin of c minus d by 2. Now can apply the formula. First one, 2 cos c plus d, 2 theta plus theta, sine c minus d, 2 theta minus theta by 2, plus cos c minus cos d, here it is minus 2 into sin of c plus d, theta plus 2 theta by 2, sin of c minus d, theta minus 2 theta by 2, that is equal to 0. Now 2 into cos of 2 theta plus theta, that is 3 theta, divided by 2, sin of 2 theta minus theta, that is a theta, divided by 2, plus into minus minus 2 into sin of 1 theta plus 2 theta, that is a 3 theta, divided by 2, and sin of theta minus 2 theta, that is equal to minus theta by 2, sin of minus theta by 2, that is equal to 0. We know that the sin of minus theta, that is equal to minus sin theta. Therefore, this becomes 2 into cos of 3 theta by 2 into sin theta by 2 minus 2 into sin of 3 theta by 2. According to this property, sin of minus theta by 2 can be written as minus sin of theta by 2. That is equal to 0. Minus into minus, plus. The next step we can write, can directly write here 2 and 2, 2 common, sine theta by 2 also common. If we take sine theta by 2, 2 sine theta by 2 is common, we will be getting here cos 3 theta by 2 minus into minus plus 2 and sine theta by 2 already common. We have sine 3 theta by 2 that is equal to 0. Now we can divide by 2. If we divide by 2, we will be getting sine theta by 2 into cos 3 theta by 2 plus sine 3 theta by 2 that is equal to 0. Now product of these two equals 0 means either sine theta by 2 equals 0 or cos 3 theta by 2 plus sine 3 theta by 2 that is equal to 0. Right? Now case 1, sin theta by 2 equals 0. Sin theta by 2 equals 0. We know that if sin x equals 0, if sin x that is equal to 0, then x that is equal to n pi where n belongs to integer. This is x, which implies x that is theta by 2 that is equal to n pi where n belongs to integer. We need theta, therefore theta that is equal, you have to cross multiply, you will be getting 2 n pi, n belongs to set of all integers. Case 1 is over. Now case 2, cos 3 theta by 2 plus sin 3 theta by 2 that is equal to 0. Case 2, cos 3 theta by 2 plus sin 3 theta by 2 that is equal to 0. Now I retain any one of them. I retain sin 3 theta by 2 that is equal to minus cos 3 theta by 2, which implies divide by cos 3 theta by 2. So sin 3 theta by 2 divided by cos 3 theta by 2 that is equal to minus 1. If we divide sin 3 theta by 2 by cos 3 theta by 2, we are getting this term. Here if we divide cos 3 theta by 2 divided by cos 3 theta by 2 that is equal to 1 only. So minus 1. Otherwise bring this term to the denominator, we will be getting minus 1 in the right hand side. Both the angles are same. What form it is? Sin theta divided by cos theta, you know very well, that is tan theta. That is tan 3 theta by 2 that is equal to minus 1. The principal solution of tan lies between minus 90 to plus 90. This is negative. So tan is negative definitely in fourth quadrant. In first quadrant all positive, fourth quadrant cos and secant only positive, tan is negative. So definitely angle will be in the fourth quadrant. So which implies tan of 3 theta by 2 that is equal to, you write this one as minus tan pi by 4, because tan 45 that is equal to 1, which implies tan of 3 theta by 2 that is equal to, we know that minus tan theta that is equal to tan of minus theta. So according to this property, this can be written as tan of minus pi by 4. Now look at the angle here, minus pi by 4 lies in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant only. If you go for that clockwise direction, that definitely the minus 45 degree in fourth quadrant only. So now we can compare these two. What form it is? Tan x that is equal to tan y, sorry, tan x that is equal to tan alpha, if tan x that is equal to tan alpha, actually tan theta equal tan alpha, since theta is in the equation itself, I consider as x. Tan x equal tan alpha, x that is equal to n pi plus alpha where n belongs to integer. That's the general solution. This is x. This one is alpha, which implies x, that is 3 theta by 2, that is equal to n pi plus alpha, that is minus pi by 4. We need theta only. So for getting theta, first you multiply by 2. If you multiply by 2, I am retaining 3 theta only here, multiply by 2. 2 into n pi, 2 n pi, plus into minus, minus. If you multiply it by 2, pi by 4 into 2, you'll be getting 2, pi by 2. Now divide by 3, you'll be getting theta. Theta, that is equal to 2 n pi minus pi by 6. Sorry, here by 3. 2 n pi by 3 minus pi by 2, 3s are 6. N belongs to integer. That is a solution. Even you can write like this, or theta, that is equal to 2 n pi by 3 plus of minus pi by 6, same only, plus into minus, minus. So n belongs to integer. So subdivision number 5 is completed. Problem number 3, subdivision 5 is completed. Then I will be teaching the next subdivision in the next video. Thank you, children. Student, this is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now problem number 3, subdivision number 6. Solve sin theta plus cos theta, that is equal to root 2. So this is of the form
sin theta, a sin theta plus b cos theta, that is equal to c.
What form it is? A cos theta plus b sin theta equal to c.
If it is, for getting the solution, divide by a root of a square plus b square. If we divide, you'll be getting a divided by a root of a square plus b square into sin theta plus b divided by root of a square plus b square cos theta, that is equal to c divided by root of a square plus b square.
Remember, if it is of the form a sin theta plus b cos theta, that is equal to c, you have to divide throughout by root of a square plus b square for getting the solution.
Now write the form a sin theta plus b cos theta, that is equal to c. Now divide by root of a square plus b square. A, that is equal to 1. I write here a, that is 1, b also 1. So 1 square plus 1 square, that is equal to root of 1 square plus 1 square, that is 2, root 2, divide by root 2. So sin theta divided by root 2 plus cos theta divided by root 2, that is equal to root 2 by root 2, that is equal to 1. Now this itself can be written as, write this term first, particularly I tell you the reason, cos theta into 1 by root 2, these two are same only, plus sin theta by root 2 can be written as sin theta into 1 by root 2, that is equal to 1. Next step, cos theta, this 1 by root 2 can be replaced by cos 45 degree plus sin theta, this 1 by root 2 can be replaced by sin 45, that is equal to 1.
So this is of the form cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. For getting this form only, I have written this term first. Okay. So this is of the form
cos of cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, that is equal to cos of A minus B.
Cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, that is equal to cos of A minus B. This is A.
A, that is theta. B, that is pi by 4, which implies cos A minus B theta minus pi by 4, that is equal to 1.
From this you have to find out the value of theta,
okay, which implies cos of theta minus pi by 4 equals the principal value of cos theta lies between 0 and 180. Lies from 0 to 180, from 0 to 180 degree. We know that cos 0, that is 1. Cos 180 is minus 1. If it is minus 1, you can write cos 180. Since it is plus 1, you have to write cos 0 degree. So what form it is? Cos x, that is equal to cos alpha. If cos x, that is equal to cos alpha, then x, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha, n belongs to integer. This is x, this entire expression is x, this is alpha. X alpha, x equals, what is x? Theta minus pi by 4, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha, alpha, that is equal to 0. 0 degree, here 0, that is the representation of angle in gradient. So, which implies, I'm retaining theta minus pi by 4, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus 0, that is equal to 2n pi only. So, I retain theta only in the left hand side, you have to find out theta only at the last, 2n pi plus pi by 4, it comes right hand side, plus pi by 4. Now, that is equal to, the LCM is 4. So, we will be getting 8n pi plus pi. We can take pi as common. If we take pi, already 4, denominator 4 as common, you will be getting 8n plus 1. Where n belongs to integer, that is theta. That is a solution. 8n plus 1 into pi by 4, n belongs to integer. So, subdivision number 6 is completed. Then I will be teaching the next subdivision in the next video. Thank you, children. Hi student, this is Sukumar. 11th standard mathematics chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now problem number 3, subdivision number 7. Solve sine theta plus root 3 cos theta, that is equal to 1. This is of the form A cos theta plus B sine theta. Even you can write A sine theta plus B cos theta, both same only, that is equal to C. Then for getting the solution, then divide by root of a square plus b square for getting the solution, remember. So what form it is? A cos theta plus b sin theta, that is equal to 1. Since I have written a cos theta first, I change it to root 3 cos theta first plus sin theta, that is equal to 1. These two are same only. Now what form it is? A cos theta plus b sin theta, that is equal to 1. A, that is equal to root 3, b, that is equal to 1. A, that is root 3, b, that is 1. So divide by root of a square plus b square, that is equal to root of a, that is root 3, root 3 the whole square, b, that is 1, 1 the whole square. That is equal to root 3 square is 3, 1 square is 1, that is equal to root 4, root 4 value is 2. So divide by 2. If we divide root 3 by 2 into cos theta, root 3 into cos theta by 2 plus sin theta divide by 2, that is equal to 1 divide by 2. This itself can be written as write cos theta first into root 3 by 2 plus sin theta into 1 by 2, that is equal to 1 by 2. Now write cos theta. This root 3 by 2 can be replaced by cos pi by 3, because cos 60 that is equal to root 3 by 2 plus sin theta into this 1 by 2 can be replaced by sin pi by this is cos 30 that is equal to root 3 by 2. So pi by 6. This is pi by 6. Sin 30 1 by 2, cos 30 root 3 by 2. Strike out, write 6 here. Pi by 6 means 30 degree. Cos 30 root 3 by 2 and sin 30 is 1 by 2. That is equal to 1 by 2. So what form it is? Cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. We know that cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, that is equal to cos of A minus B. A that is equal to theta and B that is equal to pi by 6. So which implies, according to this formula, cos of A minus B, B that is pi by 6, that is equal to 1 by 2. Which implies cos of theta minus pi by 6, that is equal to 1 by 2, which is greater than 0, positive. The principal value of cos theta lies from 0 to 180 degrees. Therefore, since it is positive, lies in which quadrant? First quadrant. So half can be replaced by cos pi by 3, cos 60 that is equal to 1 by 2. Pi by 3, 60 degree lies in which quadrant? First quadrant. So what form it is? Cos x that is equal to cos alpha. If cos x that is equal to cos alpha, then x that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha, n belongs to integer. This is x. This one is alpha, which implies x equals, what is x? Theta minus pi by 6, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha. Alpha that is equal to pi by 3. We need theta. Theta that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus pi by 3. Minus pi by 6 comes right hand side, plus pi by 6, where n belongs to integer. That's all. So subdivision number 7 is completed. Then I'll be teaching that next subdivision in the next video. Thank you, children. Hi student, this is Shivakumar, 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now question number 3, subdivision 8. Solve cot theta plus cosecant theta, that is equal to root 3. We know the formula for cot theta in terms of sine and cos. Cos theta divided by sine theta, this one, cosecant theta is 1 by sine theta, that is equal to root 3. Now we have the common denominator, sine theta. So numerator, right, as it is, cos theta plus 1, that is equal to root 3. Now cos theta plus 1, that is equal to, if you multiply, you'll be getting root 3 sine theta, which implies root 3, 1, I'm retaining 1 in the left hand side, root 3 sine theta, this one comes right hand side, minus cos theta. Or else, since you are applying cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, I am retaining that cos theta in the left hand side. Cos theta, let it be here. This one comes left hand side, minus root 3 sin theta, that is equal to plus 1 comes right hand side, minus 1. Now, what form it is? A cos theta plus B sin theta, that is equal to C. Form A cos theta plus B sin theta, that is equal to C. You know that if A cos theta plus B sin theta equal to C, then for getting the solution, divide by root of A square plus B square. okay. Now divide by a, that is 1, a that is 1 cos theta, b that is equal to minus root 3, b that is minus root 3. So divide by root of a square plus b square, that is equal to root of a value is 1, 1 square, b value is minus root 3 the whole square. That is equal to root of 1 square is 1 minus root 3 square is 3, that is equal to 4, or root 4, that is equal to 2, divide by 2. If we divide by 2, we will be getting cos theta by 2 minus root 3 sin theta divide by 2, that is equal to minus 1 by 2. This itself can be written as cos theta into 1 by 2 minus sin theta into root 3 by 2, that is equal to minus 1 by 2. So cos theta right as it is, this 1 by 2 can be replaced by cos pi by 3, that is cos 60, cos 60 that is equal to 1 by 2 minus sin theta into root 3 by 2, that is sin 60, this sin pi by 3, that is root 3 by 2, that is equal to minus 1 by 2. So this is of the form cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. You know that cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, that is equal to cos of A plus B. A that is equal to theta, this is A, this one is B, B that is pi by 3, which implies cos of A plus B, A that is theta, B that is pi by 3, that is equal to minus 1 by 2, which is less than 0. The principal value of cos, this is cos, cos lies from 0 to 180 degree, 0 to 180 degree. Here we have negative. In first quadrant all positive, in second quadrant cos is negative. So angle will be in second quadrant only. So which implies cos theta plus pi by 3 right as it is. For getting this minus half, we have tried cos of 180 minus alpha. That is alpha mean which angle is 1 by 2. Cos 60 degree that is equal to 1 by 2, that should be considered as alpha. Here theta that is equal to pi minus alpha, pi minus alpha that is pi by 3 equals, which implies cos of theta plus pi by 3 right as it is, cos of 3 into pi, 3 pi minus pi, that is 2 pi by 3. Look at that, 2 pi by 3, that is equal to 120 degree. 120 degree lies in which quadrant? Second quadrant only. So cos 120, that is equal to minus 1 by 2. Now what form it is? Cos x equal to cos alpha. We know that if cos x that is equal to cos alpha, then x that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha, where n belongs to integer. This is x, this one is alpha. Which implies x equals, what is x? Theta plus pi by 3, that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha, that is 2 pi by 3. We need theta only, so I have 3 times theta plus pi by 3 comes right hand side, minus pi by 3. So theta equals, which implies theta equals 2n pi plus or minus 2n pi plus or minus 2 pi by 3 minus pi by 3. Minus pi by 3. Where n belongs to set of all integers. So subdivision 8 is completed. Then I'll be teaching the next subdivision in the next video. Thank you, children. Hi, student. This is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now question number 3, subdivision number 9. solve tan theta plus tan of theta plus pi by 3 plus tan of theta plus 2 pi by 3, that is equal to root 3. This is of the form tan of a plus b. It is also of the form tan of a plus b. Tan of a plus b or tan of x plus y, that is equal to tan x plus tan y divided by 1 minus tan x into tan y. Here tan theta write as it is plus the tan of x plus y formula, here it is tan x, that is theta, tan y, tan of pi by 3, 1 minus tan x, that is theta, into tan y, that is tan pi by 3, plus again you have to apply the same formula, tan of x plus y, that is tan theta plus tan of 2 pi by 3 whole divided by 1 minus tan theta into tan 2 pi by 3, that is equal to root 3. Here we have tan pi by 3 and tan 2 pi by 3. Tan pi by 3, that is tan 60 degree. Tan 60 degree value is root 3. Now tan of 2 pi by 3, that is equal to tan pi by 3, that is 60 into 2, 120 degree, that is equal to tan of 180 minus 60. Since we have 180 is the first angle, we can go for that ASTC concept. ASTC, here we have 180 degree. For 180 degree, tan becomes tan angle 60 degree. 180 minus lies in second quadrant. 180 minus lies in second quadrant. Sine and cosecant only positive. Here we have tan, therefore it is negative. Minus tan 60 degree, that is equal to root 3. So minus root 3 is the value of tan 2 pi by 3. Now write tan theta as it is. Plus tan theta plus tan pi by 3, that is equal to root 3, divided by 1 minus tan theta into tan pi by 3, that is root 3, plus tan theta, tan 2 pi by 3 value here it is, that is minus root 3, divided by 1 minus tan theta into tan 2 pi by 3 value is minus root 3, that is equal to root 3. Now tan theta write as it is plus tan theta plus root 3 divided by 1 minus tan theta into root 3, you can write root 3 tan theta plus tan theta minus root 3 divided by 1 minus into minus plus tan theta into root 3 is root 3 tan theta, that is equal to root 3. Write this tan theta as it is. Here you can take the LCM. Here 1 minus root 3 tan theta, here 1 plus root 3 tan theta, multiply both. 1 minus root 3 into tan theta into 1 plus root 3 into tan theta. Since nothing is common, we have to multiply these two, tan theta plus root 3 or root 3 plus tan theta, same only, into 1 plus root 3 tan theta, plus have to multiply these two, tan theta minus root 3 into 1 minus root 3 into tan theta, that is equal to root 3. Root 3 in the right hand side. Now tan theta write as it is plus usual multiplication. Root 3 into 1 is root 3, plus root 3 into root 3 is 3, 3 tan theta, plus tan theta into 1 is tan theta, plus root 3 tan theta into tan theta, tan square theta. So root 3 tan square theta, plus tan theta into 1 is tan theta, If you multiply these two, minus root 3 tan square theta. Minus root 3 into 1 is minus root 3. Minus into minus plus root 3 into root 3, 3, 3 tan theta plus 3 tan theta whole divided by, this is of the form a plus b into a minus b, you know that a squared minus b squared, b that is root 3 tan theta the whole squared, that is equal to root 3. Since a minus b into a plus b, that is equal to a squared minus b squared. Here these two get cancelled, plus root 3 tan square theta minus root 3 tan square theta get cancelled. So left out we have tan theta plus even plus root 3 minus root 3 get cancelled. Three tan theta plus tan theta, four tan theta, five tan theta, five plus three, eight tan theta. Whole divided by one squared is one minus root three squared is three, tan theta the whole squared is tan squared theta. So three tan squared theta, that is equal to root three. Here we have 1 minus 3 tan square theta, that is a LCM, 1 minus 3 tan square theta, 1 minus 3 tan square theta equals, then have to multiply these two, tan theta into 1 minus 3 tan square theta plus 8 tan theta. Tan theta into 1 minus 3 tan square theta plus 8 tan theta, that is equal to root 3. Now we have to simplify. Multiply tan theta into 1, that is equal to tan theta minus 3 tan theta into tan square theta is tan cube theta plus 8 tan theta whole divided by 1 minus 3 tan square theta, that is equal to root 3. Together 9 tan theta minus 3 tan cube theta whole divided by 1 minus 3 tan square theta, that is equal to root 3. Here you can take 3 as common, 3 into 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by 1 minus 3 into tan square theta, that is equal to root 3. This 3 itself we can write to root 3 into root 3. This, the entire expression formula, this can be replaced by tan 3 theta. 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by 1 minus 3 tan square theta formula is tan 3 theta, that is equal to root 3. Root 3 get cancelled. So tan 3 theta, that is equal to, that is root 3 tan theta, that is equal to 1. Therefore, tan 3 theta, that is equal to 1 by root 3, which implies tan 3 theta, that is equal to 1 by root 3, that is a positive 1. The principal value of sine tan lies between minus 90 and plus 90. Since it is positive, definitely angle lies in first quadrant, so this can be replaced by tan pi by 6. Pi by 6, that is 30 degree, tan 30 degree value is 1 by root 3, 30 degree lies in first quadrant because it is a positive one. Now what form it is, this is of the form tan x, that is equal to tan alpha. We know that tan x equals tan alpha, actually tan theta equals tan alpha, since the theta is here itself, I write tan x, that is equal to tan alpha, x that is equal to n pi plus alpha, where n belongs to integer, this is x, this one is alpha, x alpha. Now x equals, what is x? 3 theta equals n pi plus alpha, alpha that is equal to pi by 6. We need theta only, so divide by 3. If we divide by 3, 3, 3 get cancelled theta. Here also I have to divide by 3, n pi by 3 plus pi by 3, 6 or if we divide by 3, 3, 6 or 18. Where n belongs to integers. However, that's a general solution. So, subdivision number 9 is completed. Then I'll be teaching that subdivision number 10 in the next video. Thank you, children. Hi, student. This is Sivakumar, 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now, problem number 3, subdivision 10. Solve cos 2 theta that is equal to root 5 plus 1 by 4. Here is subdivision number 10. Cos 2 theta, right as it is. We know that root 5 plus 1 by 4 is the value of cos 36 degrees. Cos 36 equals root 5 plus 1 by 4. Now, what form it is? This is of the form cos x that is equal to cos alpha. If cos x that is equal to cos alpha, then x equals 2n pi plus or minus alpha, where n belongs to set of all integers. This is x. This is alpha. Now, x that is equal to, that is 2 theta equals 2n pi, 2n pi plus or minus alpha, alpha that is equal to 36 degrees. We need theta. Therefore, theta equals divide by 2. 2 to get cancelled theta. If we divide by 2, 2 to get cancelled n pi plus or minus 36 degree divided by 2, that is equal to 18 degrees. So, which implies a theta that is equal to n pi plus or minus. The final answer in terms of radian, how to convert that degree into radian, 18 degrees that is equal to 18 into pi by 180. For converting degree into radian, multiplied by 180. 18 table, 10 times that is equal to pi by 10 radian. So, pi by 10, where n belongs to set of all integers. Subdivision number 10 is completed. Then I will be teaching that subdivision number 11. That is the last subdivision in this problem in the next video. Thank you, children. Hi, student. This is Sivakumar. 11th standard mathematics, chapter number 3, continuation of exercise 3.8. Now, question number 3, last subdivision number 11. Solve 2 cos squared x minus 7 cos x plus 3 that is equal to 0. Since it is a quadratic equation, we can go for splitting the middle terms. The coefficient of cos squared x is 2 multiplied with the constant 3. 2 3s are 6. Coefficient of x cos x that is equal to minus 7. Product 6 sum minus 7, the two numbers are minus 6 and minus 1. Add the two numbers, minus 7. If you multiply the two numbers, you will be getting 6. So write that 2 cos squared x as it is. Instead of minus 7 cos x, you can write minus 6 cos x minus 1 cos x plus 3 that is equal to 0. Now grouping between these two, you can take 2 cos x as common, you will be getting cos x minus 3. 2 cos x into cos x, that is 2 cos squared x minus 3 into 2 cos x, that is minus 6 cos x. We have cos x minus 3 inside the bracket, so write once again cos x minus 3. Since we have minus cos x, write minus 1. Minus 1 into cos x minus cos x. Minus 1 into minus 3 is plus 3, that is equal to 0. Between these two, you can take cos x minus 3 as common. We will be getting 2 cos x minus 1, that is equal to 0. 2 cos x minus 1. So, product of these two equals 0 means either cos x minus 3 equals 0 or 2 cos x minus 1 equal to 0. Now, case 1. Cos x minus 3 equal to 0. So, cos x that is equal to plus 3, which is greater than 1. The principal value lies from minus 1 to plus 1. The maximum of cos is plus 1 and minimum value of cos is minus 1. Since it is greater than 1, it is not possible to find the solution. Since maximum of cos value is plus 1 only. Cos, or you can write cosine, cosine, cosine value is plus 1 only. We have 3, it is not possible, which is greater than 1. Now subdivision number 2, so I mean case 2, 2 cos x minus 1 equals 0. Case 2, 2 cos x minus 1 equals 0, therefore 2 cos x that is equal to minus 1 comes right hand side plus 1. We need cos x that is equal to 1/2. 1/2, which is greater than 0, positive value. We know the principal value of cos x. Cos x lies from 0 to 180 degree. 0 degree, 180 degree. It is a positive, definitely lies in first quadrant. First quadrant, everything is positive. In second quadrant, cos x is negative. We have positive, so angle will be in that first quadrant. So which implies cos x that is equal to cos pi by 3, cos 60 that is equal to 1/2, pi by 3 is a 60 degree, that lies in first quadrant. Now what form it is? This is of the form cos theta that is equal to cos alpha. Since we have x, I write here cos theta. We know that if cos theta that is equal to cos alpha, then theta that is equal to 2n pi plus or minus alpha, where n belongs to set of all integers. This is theta, this one is alpha, which implies theta that is equal to x equals 2n pi plus or minus alpha that is equal to pi by 3. So n belongs to integer. We are asked to find out x only. We got the solution. So subdivision number 11 also completed. Then I'll be teaching the next exercise in the next video. Thank you, children.